بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، حبت في الله، أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه reported a man was once mentioned highly praised in the presence of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked them, meaning asked the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين, how is your companion's remembrance of death? They replied, we never heard him mention death. The Prophet ﷺ said, then your companion is not as you suggest. Ahabati fillah, here we find, as with many nusus, that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam called us to remember death, and that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself remembered death. So it is more than safe to say that from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to mention and remember death. So it's imperative that we reflect on how we live our life and use our life as a means to prepare for that inevitable meeting, that death awaits us all. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, في كتابه الكريم كل نفس ذائقة موت. Every soul shall taste death. Every soul shall taste death. And ahabati fillah, I want to remind myself and my brothers and sisters about a beautiful hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which I've mentioned countless times. And the dhikr tanfa'u al-mu'mineen, the remembrance, it reminds the believer. The believer has an open heart to remembering, even if they've heard it, even if they know it, even if they memorize it, they like to be remembered because it benefits a believer to be reminded. And this is the hadith which talks about the case, or talks about the fact that when we die, your deeds will cease. You don't have anything left after that. So your wealth will go, your spouse or spouses will go, your possessions, your children, everything beloved to you will leave you, and will have to move on. As loved ones, they'll have to move on with their own lives, even your spouse or spouses, that they will begin a new chapter in their life without you, and perhaps with someone else. So it shows us the importance of not attaching ourselves so much to this life, immersing our hearts and coveting everything about this life and forgetting, and at the expense of the hereafter. So the hadith I want to mention, habati fillah, is the hadith in which our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا مَاتَ الْمَرْءِ إِنْ كَتَلَ عَمَلَهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. This is a hadith in Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if a person dies, all of his deeds will cease except three. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَصَدَكَ جَارِيَةً. So he said the first thing is the continuous charity. So building a masjid, building a markaz to study the sunnah, writing books, or afwan, building a well, something that's continuous charity. That means when you die, it will remain and its benefit will remain. So you will get the reward of that. So he said, a sadaqah jariyah. And the second thing he said, al-ilm yuntufa' bih. Knowledge that the people that is benefited from. So that is good for the talib al-ilm, or the da'i ilallah, the one who calls people to the worship of Allah, whether they're calling Muslims or non-Muslims, that they are a caller. And again, the Prophet ﷺ said, al-ilm yuntafa' bih, meaning that they left knowledge with the people. So it isn't just that they called people to Islam. That's beautiful. But if they called people to Islam based on ilm and basira and fiqh, and they left behind some fiqh, then they will be rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-ilm yuntafa' bih. Mithlan, look at the imams of the Sunnah, like Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, Imam At-Tirmidhi, Imam Abu Dawood, As-Sijistani, wa ghayrihim kathir, Imam An-Nisa'i, Imam Ahmed, the four imams of fiqh. Of course, that's inclusive of Imam Ahmed. Look at what they left behind. Look at what Imam An-Nawawi has left behind, that every, you know, all the households, he has Kabul with Ahl Sunnah and Ahl Bidah. That the people loved him. And the people love him. And the people benefit from his works, Riyadh al-Salihin. Reading one hadith from that, just think of the immense benefit that that imam gains. And those who study it, think about the benefits that imam gains. Those students of knowledge and those ulama that read from it and study it and teach it and share it with the people. So that is ilm yuntafa' bih. That's knowledge that the people benefit from. And that continues. Imam Nawawi has been dead for hundreds of years. But the knowledge he left, baqi. So then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as a third thing, after saying al-ilm yuntafa' bih, he said, a waladin salih yad'u lahu. And the last thing that a person who dies that they leave behind is a righteous child that supplicates. So meaning that your children, after you die, if they supplicate and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for your forgiveness, they're asking and begging Allah, oh Allah, please forgive my father, please forgive my mother, please forgive my grandparents, please forgive my elders. They're supplicating for you. That this is also a deed that doesn't stop. And we ask Allah the Almighty to bless us with tawfiq, to be able to leave behind all of those things. So, as in order to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have that forgiveness and receive His grace and mercy and success, fi dunya wal akhirah, wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم